Can you help us understand the concept of knowledge continuity management?
Sure. The main idea is focusing on the knowledge of the critical experts. And once you identify the critical expert who is leaving his position, either leaving the company or a younger person who is promoted or leaves competitors, we use, of course, the apprentice or on-the-job training approach as every company uses and should use, but a part of that we use a structured process as well. This structured process is built of six steps. First step is identifying the critical expert, which we do in a very efficient way, where it's done mainly by the HR person and the business leader who knows who is the critical expert and whose expertise is not redundant and then, of course, supports future business. Second step is mapping the expert's knowledge and whether this knowledge is already documented or needs to be documented, prioritizing the various steps in the processes and the various technologies he's referring to in order to find the critical knowledge, considering my approach of 575, meaning identifying the 5% which is critical and has the effectiveness of which is 75%. The third step will be actually capturing the knowledge by documentation, by building e-learning modules, by taking video shoots like this one, or by writing standards and building best practices. The next step, as now we already have knowledge assets, the next step will be designing and building a very user-friendly performance support knowledge base, which is a site where we put all the knowledge assets and they are organized in a very user-friendly manner. The emphasis is that people can access the needed knowledge asset very easily. The next step, which is actually the fifth step, is assimilation of the knowledge assets in the site itself, so that the colleagues of the next expert, meaning the expert who is replacing the living expert, will know as well what is in this site, how to get to the site easily, and what is the benefit of the content in this site for the jobs. Last, but for sure not the least, the sixth step, has to do with monitoring what we have done, meaning going back to the group with which we are working and see whether they are using the content in the site, if there are any problems, what are the problems so that we can help them solve them so that the site will be kept alive. As we don't want to build something unless we are sure that it's useful and it supports the business, meaning for engineers, the development procedures, and for others, whatever that they are doing, it can be either in companies like us, but it could be a hospital or an insurance company or a bank, whatever. The same problems and the same solution.